I found the pop movement on one side an invigorating change. On another side, I thought it was a little comic. I mean, they were trying to, and many of the works became too trite. But then it is true that the whole question is, they were becoming alive to the scene that was, not thinking in terms of a certain studio scene which they are imagining. And that there was a kind of an aesthetic reward in even in the scene that was. That I can agree. And then to that extent, I also was interested in using methods where such things could be sort of brought up. Maybe that is why I reacted or at least learned lessons from what you call bazaar painting and then started doing glass painting. Though I didn't know the whole method of glass painting at that time, when I saw a whole assortment of glass painting with one of my old students who had made a collection here, that is when it all started. That should be, I think, in the end of the 70s.
Later, sir.
Then I saw that glass paintings had many variations. Of course, I didn't know the history of glass painting at that time. But then he had a whole variety of glass painting. There were portraits, I mean, there were icons, and there were mythological stories, all illustrated. But the common way was that immediacy of rendering, and a kind of a, when it was close to the surface of the air, there is no way of either you rub it out or keep it on, and then when you put the color behind, it comes out, glows out of the glass. And that kind of a transformation and immediate rendering takes on, that seemed interesting to me. As well as the kind of a thing, the common things that it sort of tried to represent. But when it comes through with such a sort of the glass, so close to the glass, and then you put all the color in, then they become iconic in themselves, even the common things become iconic. So that is where I started doing glass painting. Then rather, I found that a glass painting has a great advantage for a man who is interested in using drawing in various ways. So because I always worked with gouache color, then backed it up with oil or sealed it in. So with gouache color, you can go on sort of experimenting on glass and wiping them away and putting things in and all. So you see, it was easy to engraft various kinds of things together and then finally finish it by this oil paint. And that I still find very challenging and very diverting, and I enjoy doing it. So you can do something which is very informal in glass painting. You can do something which is more formal and organized in glass painting. Both things are possible and very easily.